Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, I shall provide an answer to my question raised in the previous video. We shall also discuss the heat conduction in liquid and in gas. In the last video, I have a question about an experiment in which two aluminium rods of the same length but different thickness are stuck with a joint pin at one end by melted wax and heated at the other end. My question is, which joint pin will fall first? The experiment has been carried out and is shown here. Result shows that the joint pin of the thicker rod will fall first. This experiment shows that the rate of heat conduction in a thicker rod is faster. Let's summarize the factors that affect the rate of conduction in a solid. Firstly, material. Metal has a higher rate of heat conduction than non-metal. Secondly, the thickness of the rod. A thicker rod has a higher rate of heat conduction. Thirdly, length of the rod. A longer rod has a lower rate of heat conduction. Fourthly, temperature difference between the two ends. A larger temperature difference will give a higher rate of heat conduction. Now, let's consider the heat conduction in water. Put ice and water into a boiling tube. The ice falls near the water surface. A wire gauge is used in order to keep the ice at the bottom of the boiling tube. Now, heat the boiling tube by a Bunsen burner with the flame near the water surface. Very soon, boiling occurs, but this confines to the water near the surface. At the same time, you can see ice remaining at the bottom of the boiling tube. Here, the boiling water is at 100 degrees Celsius, and the ice is at 0 degrees Celsius, and they coexist in the same boiling tube. We can even touch the part of the boiling tube where ice can be found. However, never touch the part where water boils. The temperature of the water inside the tube ranges from 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. This experiment shows that water is not a good heat conductor. Now, let's consider the heat conduction through air. A matchstick is moved horizontally towards the flame of a Bunsen burner. You can see that even the matchstick is less than 1 cm from the flame, it does not ignite. This shows that air is a good heat insulator or a poor heat conductor. Question: if the matchstick is moved from above, it will be ignited quickly. How do you explain this? Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. In summary, water and air are poor heat conductor. This can be understood because molecules in a gas or in a liquid do not collide as frequently as those in the solid counterpart. As a result, liquid molecules and gas molecules do not exchange their energy easily. Vacuum cannot conduct heat because there is no molecules to carry the energy. I hope this video can help you understand more about heat conduction. Thank you for watching.